Hello, hello. Thanks for tuning in. Today we wanted to show you a low-cost, pure sine wave inverter made by ALFFAA. It's a 1500 watt. It converts 12 volt DC to 110 volt AC. It has some outlets and some USB ports. It does not come with cables. This is all you get in a box with an instruction manual. So we'll take a look at the front here. And on the front, we have your AC voltage, AC amperage, battery voltage, two 120 outlets, your on-off switch, and two 2.1 amp USBs. On the back here, you have two cooling fans and your battery hookups. Again, does not come with cables. You will have to make your own cables. Here is the specification sheet with it. It's pure sine wave. It seems to have a peak power of 1700 and an overload of 1800 watts. Input battery voltage is 10 to 15 volts, so I'm assuming the low shutoff is around 10. It has a fuse on it, but it looks like it's probably going to be internal. So let's get some battery cables made up, and we'll get this thing hooked up. If you see there, lower than 10.5, it'll send a beep alarm. When it's lower than 10, it will automatically shut down. So we will get it tested and see how well this thing works. We have our 100 amp hour battery there set up on our solar system. So it is fully charged. We'll get the cables hooked up and see what we got. Okay, we have a very hasty setup going on just to show it. We will turn the power on. And there it is, 110 volts, 14.7. The first thing we will turn on is this little heater here. And this is 400 watts. So it is on maximum. And it is running it. We will turn on this fan, which is gonna be a good test because this is an old fan. So if it makes noise and buzzes, we know that the inductive load is not good. And it is running perfect. So as we can see, we are bringing down 2.3 amps, 112 volts, no problems, everything's running. Everything's working well. All right, we'll test the USB ports and we'll get a heavier load on this thing. All right, now that we confirm that this definitely is a pure sine wave inverter, again, the instructions, let's see what the output is here. Output says 110, so yeah, it's definitely meeting the specifications. We have a 1500 watt heater here, and the 400 watt one here, which should technically max this thing out. So let's go ahead and turn these heaters on and see what we got. Right now, that's just the fan on. That's about half the power. Still maintaining 110, which is great. Now we're bumped it up to the full 1500 watts. And as you can see there, it's maintaining 110 volts. Coming up on 7 amps. And it's drawing the battery down pretty quick. But I'm looking at the other monitor up top and we're showing 12.4. I'm not sure if you guys, there you go, 12.3. Again, it's a hasty hookup, so nothing's permanent. So it's performing really well for what it is. And we'll get this other 400 watt one, and this thing is pumping out heat right now. We'll turn this on max as well. So that's a total of 1900 watts. and there's no motor hum, no nothing going on. You see there, we're pulling down almost 11 amps out of there, and we're still maintaining the 110 volts AC. Oh, we just passed 11. That's the low voltage alarm kicking on. I'm looking at the other meter. We're still at about 11.8, so we're still good. But as you see there, it's just hammering it down. It's no fault of the inverter. It's obviously the battery. But we are running both of these at maximum capacity. Again, this one's 1,500 watts. This is 400 watts. That's a total of 1,900 watts. We are over what the manufacturer stated. So this little thing is doing very well. So we're going to go ahead and turn it off. And we're going to go ahead and test the USB ports there. Okay, we have a load device hooked up to the USB ports here. And you see it's putting out 5.13 volts DC. We're going to go ahead and turn the load on, and we'll bring it up to about a half amp. Now again, these things are rated for 2.1, it said. So if you see there, let me get a better view for you guys, sorry. There we are. Get that light back on there. So we'll bring it up to 1 amp. And we're at an amp now. Bring it up to 1.5 amps. There's 1.5, and we're still maintaining that 5.13. Bring it up to 2 amps. So at 2 amps, this thing's gonna charge almost any device. Let's bring it up to 2.5 amps. There it is, 2.5 amps. Let's see what we can get. 2.75. Let's go to 3. I suspect it'll start cutting out soon. There's 3. And the voltage has not changed. There's 3.5 amps. This thing can really kick out some power. Oh, and it cut off at around 3.75, did it? Let's see. Nope, it's still going. We are at 4 amps, ladies and gentlemen. And it cut out. So it will do 4 amps out of one socket. Let me switch it and see if we can get the other one. All right, we went to the top port there. And we are at 3-4 amps again. So that is amazing. Each one of these USBs can hold 4 amps. Absolutely amazing. And again, this thing is doing good. So we're gonna get a bigger load on here and see what we actually max out at. All right, we would just wanted to hook up the kilowatt meter to show everybody that there's no tricks or anything going on, to show that it's actually a pure sine wave. This is the 1500 watt heater. And as you can see there, we are running over 1,000 watts at 60 Hertz. 9.38 amps. So it's a little off there. It's not much, but it's a little off. But as you can see, we are running about 1,100 watts from this thing. So no issues at all right now. And again, this is the 1,500 watt ALFFAA. And that's just the low battery warning, not worried about that. But we're steadily pulling down 1,100 and we'll call 1,150 watts. So we'll check the other smaller heater here and we'll add those together because we did have both of those running. Oh, and just wanted to show you, the fans do cut on. They're a little noisy, not too bad though. All right, we're gonna turn the small heater on max. Drawing down about an amp. Again, 60 Hertz. So with both heaters running, we were pulling really close to the 1500 watts it stated, and it was doing it no problem. We'll go ahead and get a pretty hard load hooked up, which is a heater here. It is a 1500 watt heat gun. This thing goes well over 1500 watts on high, so we'll see what it can stabilize at. And most of the time, inverters can't handle this thing because it is just too much of an inductive load to start. But we'll see what we got. Okay, we have both heaters hooked up to the kilowatt meter there. And as you can see, it is 60.1 hertz. We're gonna go ahead and check the watts and go ahead and turn both on and see what we max out at. That's the smaller heater. We got the larger heater on the first setting, and we'll let everything kind of stabilize out. And now we'll bump it up to the max setting. So both heaters are now at the maximum setting. As you can see, we're pulling down about 8 amps right now, and it's still climbing. So we're over 1,000 watts now. We will check the amp draw. We're at 10.5 amps, so it's not too far off. And the watt is there. We're pulling down about 1,200 watts. And that's just the low battery alarm kicking off. So about 1,200 watts there. Not too bad. We dropped everything off. So we're gonna hook the fan up now and run the fan and see what the fan draws down, and we'll get all that stuff added up together. Okay, we have all three plugs plugged in. The two heaters and the large fan here. So we're gonna go ahead and turn the fan on high and see what we get. All right, the fan is on high and we're running just under 100 watts. The heater is now on high. And we're turning the big heater on now. And the big heater's on high, so everything is running on high right now. And again, that's just the low voltage alarm for the battery. So it's pulling 1200 watts, no problem. Let's see if we can get this thing up any higher. All right, we're gonna go ahead and try and set this thing up for maximum usage here. We're gonna go ahead and turn the fan on high. We got the fan on high, it's about 100 watts. We got the heater on now. All right, we're hitting 1300. And I think it kicked off because of the battery cable. So we've seen that it goes straight up to 1300. It's honestly probably the hasty setup I have here. Okay, we moved the setup over and we have it on a battery charger so we can get the maximum voltage into this thing. We're using 8 gauge cable. I would definitely recommend using 6 or larger because these do get a little warm. So we're gonna go ahead and check what we got on the watt meter here. And 109 volts, 108. That's just the dead load from the equipment being on. But you see we're at 60 hertz. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna fire up the heater. Let that thing level out. All right, we're already at 600 watts. Go ahead and jump it up with the heat gun here. And as you see, we're already pulling 1250. Going on to 1300 watts out of the 1500 rated. We'll bump it up a little higher here. And there we are. We're over 1500 watts and everything still is powering. We're drawing down 15 amps. So I'll bring it back down. We're on the low setting again. You see there, we're pulling 1300 watts consistently, no issues from this thing. The fan's just kicked on. We're at about 1400 watts, and that's the low voltage alarm on the battery clicking off. As you can see there, no issues maintaining 1300 plus watts. We'll jump it up again. And look, we're over 1500 watts right there. And I'm maxing it out now, and we're gonna see where it cuts off. All right, so it cut off at just over 1500 watts or so. It spiked because we're using this inductive heater here and this small grid heater here. So yeah, this thing definitely puts out what it's rated at a pure sine wave. So it's a good buy if you want a cheap small inverter. Just make sure you're using 6 gauge or better because these cables are very warm right now. And that's the limiting factor here. I think we could have drawn way close to that 1800 watts it was talking about. So I hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.